Hello, my name is John Yang. I'm a high school senior, and I'm here to present my small business today, Roundabout, a one-of-a-kind multi-destinational mapping service. So before I delve into the business itself, I'd like to give you a bit of background. From where I'm from, the Bay Area, every day is a hustle and bustle of traffic, and that got me thinking. Google Maps and Apple Maps were always my resort to being able to circumvent all the traffic and find the best route between location A and location B. But that got me thinking. I usually visit multiple places every day. So why isn't there a mapping service out there that allows you to enter point A, B, and also C? And that's where the concept of multi-destination comes in. Roundabout starts off as an iOS app. The app allows you to enter multiple locations in the list. Then it optimizes these locations, ordering them in the most distance-efficient manner. Then it saves the route locally to your mobile phone and computer so that you can reference it in the future. Here are a few pictures of what the app looks like. So here you can enter a name for your route, enter the starting location, and then put in the list of destinations you'd like to visit. Then, using an inbuilt algorithm, the app optimizes the route and then displays it with the starting location, traverses through all the additional locations entered, and then finds the end location. But if you're not a visual person, then there's also a list right here, giving you the order by order point A to B, B to C, C to D, and so on. It also gives you statistics for your route, such as the total distance and the total estimated time it will take to complete your multi-destinational path. And whenever you're ready, simply click on one of these cells, you'll redirect to the navigation page, confirm start and end location, click navigate, and you'll be on your way. So, Roundabout is a multi-destinational service, and therefore I tried to identify some customers. These would involve delivery, business, and salespeople, people who are involved in the day-to-day task of visiting multiple customers, picking up multiple donations, or delivering multiple products, and want to do it in the most distance-efficient manner possible. For example, below, I received a user input who rated my app, and he said, "Wonderful app, especially for those who want to visit a lot of places at once. If you're a realtor, delivery person, or anyone like that, then download this." And that essentially embodies the role and skill that Roundabout provides for users. To give you a few statistics, the app was released in August 11th, 2015. I've updated it 3 times since, and it is currently free on the App Store. Up till today, the app has around 1,000 App Store views, over 300 downloads in 20 countries, and most importantly, a 70% retention rate. Now, this number really affirmed my belief that Roundabout has the potential to go in as a small business. In these past months, I've done a bit of user testing with a food donation service called Mezzo and the Tech Museum of Innovation, a nationally acclaimed museum in San Jose. Both of these are using Roundabout for their day-to-day logistics and provided me with a set of additional features that I'm considering. So once again, Roundabout optimizes your route by distance efficiency. Rather, now I'm thinking about implementing time efficiency, building and optimizing the route by the shortest amount of time rather than distance it'll take to go from one point to the other. In addition, there's also manual route editing thanks to time and urgency parameters. So what that really means is if a user, due to some business meeting or meetup, needs to visit one location before the other, despite the optimized efficiency, they can simply change the order of the route itself. Last but not least, there's their dynamic updating and user friendliness, making the app more logical and easier to understand for the user. Delving into the more business side of Roundabout. As for the market size, I believe Roundabout is a very select service in a market that has the potential to grow. These markets include individual users, many of my customers now, small businesses, and I believe Roundabout has the greatest potential for medium-sized delivery corporations. In these past few weeks, I've talked to a few businesses such as Waiter.com, Sal's Airport and Limousine Service, and Second Harvest, all of whom are involved in delivering customers, products, or donations in the most efficient manner possible. And that affirms the fact that there is a substantial market for Roundabout. As for a business model going forward, I'm thinking about first placing in in-app purchases. In order for users to access all those additional features stated before, I'll charge them a small fee. But the real potential for Roundabout lies in the mid-sized and small businesses. And there's really three categories of businesses Roundabout can be used for. First and foremost is transportation. With companies such as Lyft and Uber, we're really good at picking up one person and sending them to one destination, Roundabout may present the opportunity to pick up multiple people and send them to multiple destinations with more profit without sacrificing the quality of their service. Food, for such as the Bay Area's famous Z Pizza or Zero Cater, both of which are involved in delivering food to people, can take on more customers and more product with the efficiency presented by Roundabout. And last but not least, shipping. This is similar to the food concept. And while Google Shopping Express and Walmart Grocery To Go probably has their own system of route optimizing in place, businesses that are similar to any of these two could definitely find Roundabout very useful. Thank you to the judges for listening to my presentation. Thank you once again to Seton Hall alumni, faculty, and students for providing this great opportunity. And last but not least, good luck to all of the other 9 competitors there. Thank you.